In this video, we are going to revisit this Pilot Metropolitan fountain pen. I released a video 2 or 3 weeks ago and gave sort of a review of this pen. And since then, I've used it daily. I mean, every day, quite a bit. And it has finally ran out of ink. As you can see, I'm kind of out here in nature today. I've been, as you can see, I was riding my bike, and I've taken a break right here at this picnic table. There's a little bit of a breeze, and I'm not sure how the quality of the audio will turn out on this video. As you can see, the pen is skipping, and it's about out. So, right here at this picnic table, I'm going to flush the ink from this pen. And as you may or may not recall, this ink was Noodler's Widow Maker. It's kind of a deep, deep red. And after I flush the pen, I'm going to put some, let's see if I can adjust the focus. Ancient Copper is the color, and this ink was made by Diamine. So let's flush the pen. I need to reposition the camera. Okay, as you can see, I have 2 disposable cups. I need some water. If you watched my review video on this pen, you remember me telling you that rather than a traditional ink converter, this one has the squeeze type. And all you have to do is squeeze these 2 tongs together and release it to draw ink from the bottle into the pen. Well, squeezing them together will also push ink out of the pen. This is kind of a bladder, just a little rubber sack. And when I squeeze it, you'll see what I'm talking about. Yes, friends, there wasn't much ink left in this pen at all. I'm sitting next to a garbage can, so I'm going to dump this and refill it. I would say it's flushed out pretty good. As you can see, the water is clear. So let me empty that or set this off to the side. This pen has taken a lot of abuse since you and I last talked about it. It's been dropped at least a couple of times. One time it was dropped in a men's public restroom. The cap was still on it, but the cap came off as soon as the pen hit the floor. There was no damage done. But the pen did need to be disinfected. Quite honestly, I stood there for just a moment, looking at the pen, noticing where it lay. And it wasn't a pretty sight. And for a few seconds, I felt like just walking out and leaving the pen to the elements, so to speak. But after about 30 seconds, I decided to go ahead and pick it up. And I spent the next several minutes disinfecting the pen as well as myself. But even after being dropped a couple of times, the pen did not take not even a scratch. Okay, let's put some of this ancient copper ink made by Diamine into the pen. I'll give it a couple more squeezes. Okay, let me readjust the camera. Diamine Ancient Copper. I'm going to take these bicycling gloves off because I cannot write with these on. You may recall me telling you in the previous video concerning this pen about the transition from the section to the barrel and how it was rather short from here to here. And as someone who tends to hold the pen further up rather than way down here, this transition area was kind of uncomfortable, but I've been writing with a pen every day for 2 or 3 weeks now, and I've gotten sort of used to it. I'm sitting in the shade, and the lighting in the shade here is probably not going to do the color of this ink justice. So, rather than writing, I think I'll just draw a truck. Or try to. Recently, I had a subscriber suggest that I make a video where I answer questions about myself. I told the subscriber that I was not necessarily opposed to it, but I couldn't answer any questions that I felt were too personal, and I told him I would think about it. And I'm still thinking about it. I believe the last time I did some of this picnic table pinning, I drew a, what is known as a conventional cab, truck, semi. And what I'm drawing now is known as a cab over. With a conventional cab, the truck, or tractor is what you would actually call it, has a long hood, and the engine sits underneath. With a cab over tractor, the cab is, well, it's over the engine. And I can't believe that already I've messed up this drawing. But it's okay. You don't see these cab over tractors much anymore. They were pretty popular in the 60s and the 70s. If any of you watching this video is in the industry of trucking, you could probably answer the question about why they don't use this style anymore. Perhaps it's because of gas mileage. This big flat face isn't very aerodynamic, not very streamlined. And I wouldn't be surprised if that is the reason. Having said that, the cab overs are still my favorite type of semi. Now this pen has a medium nib, but it writes like a fine. I suppose I should go ahead and get some kind of a wheel down here. which for me is the hardest part of it. Trying to determine how tall that's over. It's tough. Yeah, it's about right. I need one on the other side. It's okay. Trying to remember the configuration for the gas tank is sort of tricky, but first I'll do a battery box. Which also serves as sort of a step. And then some fuel tank, a fuel tank. Put the straps on that hold the tank. In a cap. Then I believe there's a chain that keeps the cap from getting lost. Rails. Here's just a small compartment. I don't know what the weather is like where you are. But it's a comfortable day today where I'm at. It's in the low 60s. A drink of water. I guess I should put some exhaust stacks in here somewhere. I'm gonna need some running lights. Couple of nice air horns. And of course, the second stack. The truck's just not a truck without dual stacks. Well, I just got a message on my phone that my battery is starting to weaken. So I'm going to turn the camera off, finish this up, and show it to you. Well, there you have it. A 1970s cab over semi-tractor drawn with a Pilot Metropolitan fountain pen in Diamine Ancient Copper ink. Thanks for watching.